Hey, Shalom, Shalom. I give all praise, honor, and glory to Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai. Barakat the Yahweh, Barakat the Yahweh Shai, Barakat the Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai, Barakat the Rakakadash. Okay, double honors to our apostles of Great Millstone, our elders of GMS. Okay, and salutation, peace, and much blessings to your hopeful elect fellow laborers of the children of Israel, the 12 tribes. Okay, Israelite foreigners that's been scattered amongst the four corners of the earth. All right, they have the spirit of an Israelite, the spirit. Okay, and you women as well. You're awkward, okay? Just a quick, quick lesson, as you know. Cause it's a reminder, and a reality check as well. What we're witnessing and what we're experiencing is the majority of the people. You know, Israelites who I'm speaking of, they have to see things to believe it. They have to see it to believe it. So if it's not present, you know, then they're just going to continue on in their foolish blindness and wickedness, you know, because that's pretty much how Jake is, you know. And if you notice that Jake only reacts when there's controversy, when there's, whenever there's drama, you know, which pretty much that's what arouses them. Which is almost it almost falls into that same category as seeing something, and with them seeing something, they're reacting, you know, meaning that they're just pretty much a lack of faith, you know, and like the scripture says, how the harvest is plenty and laborers are few, that's in a direct result of that, you know, and if they're not seeing something that's worthy or at that level of grabbing attention and keeping it and having them follow it or reacting to it, they're just going to continue on their blind path. But again, the harvest is plenty and laborers are few. And what Apostle Tahar mentions every once in a while is a lot of the churches, how they're going to be scattered, especially those that are not teaching the full doctrine and laboring and keeping the full doctrine, and that are subverting the doctrine and butchering the scriptures. Or how he mentions how they're going to scatter those houses, those churches, how they're going to scatter, because there's going to be a major shakeup, you know, and that major shakeup is something they're going to experience, something they're going to see, you know, and then they're going to actually come look for the true prophets, you know. But that's just part of what's going to that has to go down, you know. But you know how the wacky tacky Christians are, how in anything of their beliefs and their doctrine is literally have nothing to do with the scriptures. It literally has nothing to do with the scriptures, and pretty much they're under that belief of, you know, they may quote a scripture here and there, quoting one with as far as being able to see, not being able to see. This the scripture I'm referring to is we're guided by faith and not by sight. I know I roughly paraphrased it, but they may quote those scriptures, but they don't exactly believe those scriptures. You know, they don't exactly believe, because if you really look and talk to a Christian, I had an eye opener yesterday, and that's pretty much what opened my eyes, that these people may be reading the scriptures, but they don't actually believe the scriptures. They may quote scriptures here and there, but they literally don't believe the scriptures, because once they open their mouths, it's totally contrary to the whatever scriptures they may quote. Even though I'm not saying they quote a script, because they don't use scripture. You know, they go off with their rant. They rant, you know, with some emotional rant, you know, thinking that they're sounding godly. And like the scripture says, they have an unction for the Most High, but not according to knowledge. And that's the normal, that's the average Israelite. They have an unction for the Most High, but not according to knowledge. You know, now they may acknowledge the power when controversy and when when they face when they're faced with a challenge, life-threatening, physical harm, loved ones leaving them, when they're faced with controversy, you know, and that's a way of seeing, you know, that's another way of seeing, you know, seeing and experiencing. You know what? Let me do this. Just go into the scripture here. Let me see. Let me see what it gives me. Just look, hit the word seeing here. I'm going to go to the New Testament. That's where a lot of the good stuff. We look at the whole book as the good stuff. But, you know, they tend to think that because there's a New Testament that lost and changed, the Lord then changed, where they're totally off with that. Totally lost their goddamn minds. Okay, let me see here. Let me see what I got here. By faith, he forsook Egypt, not fearing the wrath of the king, for he endured, as seeing him who invisible. Wherefore, seeing we also are compassed about with so great a cloud of witness. Let me hit this Hebrews 12 and 1. Just seeing what it gives me with, as far as the word seeing. Seeing we also. Yes, we also added on to it. So it might be different in another scene. And also even, indeed, but. Apparently a primitive part of having a comparative and sometimes also commutative force. And also even, so then too, etc. Often used in connection or composition with other particles or small words, and also both, but even, for, if, or, so, that, then, therefore, we, when, and yet. Okay, let me get another one. Let me go into another one. Just seeing what gives me the word seeing. I'm seeing we are compassed about seeing ye have purified your souls, but the righteous man dwelleth among them in seeing and hearing. Let me look for it. Let me look up C. The word C instead. Look, it's, you should have known C was in here a lot of times. Let me go here. You know what? There's one that's coming to mind, and it's Acts, John. Acts, let me go to Acts. Let me go in here. But we have hope for that we see not. But if we hope for that we see not, then do we with patience wait for it. That's the spirit we're in. That's the spirit we see. Okay, to see, discern. Okay. So I'm looking for one which is referring to the ungodly, or the unbelievers. They see not, neither do they understand. Let me think for a second where that would be. Let me do this. That which I see not, teach thou me. And now men see not the bright light. And let their eyes be darkened that they see not. Let me get Psalms, but I want a New Testament. Here we go, John 12 and 40. He hath blinded their eyes and hardened their heart, that they should not see. They don't discern. They're not discerning. To see with their eyes, to see with the wind, to perceive. And that's what they're not seeing. They're not perceiving that these prophecies are taking place. They don't perceive looking at the world. They don't see what's going on. You know, reading the scriptures tell us to watch, you know, to watch in all things. You see? And we're watching all things. So we're seeing everything that's, we can literally see the destruction and the downfall of this kingdom take place. You know, to perceive, to know, to see, become acquainted with by experience. So they're not seeing, they're, you know, so in other words, they're not capable in spirit to follow that straight gate. So they're going to just go with the norm, the wide gate, you know, where everybody else is going. It has to be the popular route. You know, which, what does it say in the scripture? Broad is the way that leadeth to destruction. Okay. So it, again, they can't perceive, you know, to take heed and beware, to care for, pay heed to, to discern clearly. Okay. Here we go. Properly to stare at. By implication, to discern clearly, and they can't discern clearly the path to take physically or mentally, by extension, to extend. Okay, here we go. So these people can't discern that from the truth and from lies and from falsehood, and you know. So let me do this here. I'm going to go to y'all. Second Ezra, the 7th chapter. Excuse me. Ooh, I'm outside these allergies. I'm starting at the top here. Okay, 2nd Ezra 7:1. And then when I had made an end of speaking these words, there was sent unto me the angel which had been sent unto me the nights before. And he said unto me, Up, Ezra, and hear the words that I am come to tell thee. And I said, Speak on, my power. Then said he unto me, The sea is set in a wide place, that it might be deep and great. But put the case, the entrance, were narrow and like a river. Who then could go into the sea to look upon it and to rule it? If he went not through the narrow, how could he come into the broad? And there's a movie the name of it is escaping me, but they were on a, they were stuck in a rainforest, a dense forest somewhere in Brazil or somewhere, and they were faced with all kinds of dangers in that forest. They were in a river, a whitewater river, going through this forest, something like the rainforests of Brazil. Or South America. But anyway, they were faced with all kinds of dangers and they were fighting the whole time, literally fighting the whole time, the whole movie, you know, and in that voyage of theirs, in that mission of theirs, trying to escape up out of the wilds, there were loss of lives, you know, there were some that ended up injured along the way. But ultimately, when they got to the end of those white waters and out of danger, they came to an ocean. They came into a quiet ocean. And I'm not sure if it was an ocean or a massive lake. But when they finally got to that massive lake, they finally made it to safety. You know, they finally made it to safety. And there's a couple examples of movies like that, but this one particular one was an old school sci-fi one. I can't remember the name of it. Well, anyway, they finally got to the oceans, and that's when the movie ended. You know? And that's reading this, and that's what brings to mind. So let me continue on reading. It said, but put the case, the entrance were narrow and like a river, white waters, okay, who then could go into the sea to look upon it and to rule it. And he went through, and he went not through the narrow. How could he come into the broad? And that's the same with the way with the people of the world. They're choosing the broad, the easy path. The easy path. And I'm going to bring it to light again, especially using IUIC as an example. That's the 100,000 man march camps, right? Imagine if half of those individuals were setting up camp on the highways and the byways, and what difference it would make. You would see it, but you already know those $100,000 men marching camps. You know they're not laboring. You know they're not setting up camps. You know they're not. You know they're taking the easy way out, and that's the way of the world. The churches as well, Christian, Baptist, whatever them bullshit denominations that are not of Yahweh, but Shem Yahweh Shai. They all carry the same characteristics. You know, let's follow the popular. Let's find safety amongst the masses. You know, but that's not according to the Lord. Finding safety amongst the moat where are the masses of the people. You know, so it says, who then could go into the sea to look upon it and to rule it, if he went not through the narrow? And the narrow is the straight, the difficult path, which you see the prophets, the true prophets, are following, the narrow path. How could he come into the broad? There's also another thing. A city is built and set upon a broad field. These are parables. And it is full of a good things, all good things. The entrance thereof is narrow and is set in a dangerous place to fall, like as if there were a fire on the right hand and on the left a deep water. And one only path between them both, even between the fire and the water, so small that there could but one man go there at once. If this city now were given unto a man for an inheritance, if he never shall pass the danger set before it, how shall he receive the inheritance? So that's a beautiful question. Listen, if this city now were given unto a man for an inheritance, if he never shall pass the danger set before it, how shall he receive the inheritance? Now you see where I went with this, where I'm going, you know, and you can see how the true prophets, we're taking that narrow path, the dangers, you know, we're faced with all these dangers and we're seeing them, how they're going to come after the prophets as far as being false accusers, you know, going to accuse us of all forms of things like treason and so on and so on. You know, so all that time is coming where the people are going to, I mean, that's the danger we see. That's the danger that we see. And it's part of the straight gate. The dangers is part of the straight gate, you know. And like I said, when I was giving reference to this movie, this old sci-fi movie that I was watching, that there were some lost. And like the scripture says, there were some that were beheaded for a witness for Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai. All right. And this is that part of that. This is part of the ministry, man. The difficult, the dangers. All right. So it says here, and I said, it is so, Lord. Then said he unto me, even so also is Israel's portion. See, this is our portion, and there's no way around it. You know, it's either the straight gate or the broad gate, and the majority is going to take the broad. Okay, and that few was going to take the narrow, because for their sakes I made the world, and when Adam transgressed by statute, then was the decree that now is done. Adam's foolishly taking on them crazy doctrines that his wife Eve brought home, you know, foolishly taking them on. You know, and as I say again, Eve had to have been a bad bitch. Just imagine, you know, so fine, so chocolatey, and that he couldn't turn it down, man. that beauty, you know, and that's the problem with a lot of us, a lot of men. They get so, they get blinded by that beauty and get stuck on stupid, literally, you know. I've had many beautiful women that, you know, I still remember to this day. Just there were certain women that I would be in their presence. I would be just staring at them. I would just stare at them. Literally stare. Just, you couldn't help just that beauty, man. But you know, in all reality, you don't, you know, the average women that I've been with were always my favorite. The ones I got along better with, the ones I was able to grow better with, you know, it's always the more average one. You know, that beauty is a dagger, man. You know. Anyway, let me get back into this. Because for their sake I made the world, and when Adam transgressed my statutes, then was decreed that now is done. Then were the entrances of this world made narrow, full of sorrow and travail. And there we go, backs our word up. Full of sorrow and travail. They are but few and evil, full of perils and very painful. You see? And what does the scripture say? Let me just get it. Seven and seven, surely oppression maketh a wise man mad, and it gives destroyed the hearts. Okay. Better is the end of a thing than the beginning. This is the end of this world. I had to read that one. You know, it's the end of this world. You know, and with this end, with this world going out in this end, man, that's gonna, you know, you. That's why we're going to experience a lot of the bitter and a lot of those. What did the scripture say? What did that scripture say? What did it say again? Here we go. It says, then were the entrances of this world made narrow, full of sorrow and travail. But they are but few and evil, full of evils. That end, again, you know, that, you know, we're waking up to it. You know, and this is what we're going to be faced with, a lot of evil in these times, full of perils and very painful these last days, man. You know, so it says here, for the entrance of the elder were wide and short and brought immortal fruit. You know, this world is full of death, man. You know, this world rejects life. Okay, it's full of death. In its ways, it leads you to death, immortal fruit. It's like I quoted that wrong. I broke that down wrong. Immortal is not being able to die. You know. Okay, so here we go. And then they that live labor not to enter these strait and vain things, they can never receive those that are laid up for them. Now therefore, why disquietest thou thyself, seeing thou art but a corruptible man? And why art thou moved, whereas thou art but mortal? Why hast thou not considered in thy mind this thing that is to come, rather than that which is present? So let me read that again. Why hast thou not considered in thy mind this thing that is to come? You know, because they were blinded. You know, ultimately, when you look down into it, the angels blinded them. You know, Yahweh Bashem Yahshua blinded them so that they can't see. You know, and like the scripture says, neither do they understand. Let me get that in Matthew's. Rather than that which is present. Okay. Because this present world is on its way out. And you find yourself explaining that to someone, and that's where they fall into. They can't see. They can only see what's present. You know? That's in their spirit. They only see what's present. Let me get this here. Here we go, Matthew 13:12. For whosoever hath, to him shall be given, and he shall have more abundant. But whosoever hath not, from him shall be taken away even that he hath. Therefore speak I to them in parables, because they seeing see not, and hearing they hear not, neither do they understand. You see? And in them is fulfilled the prophecy of Isaiah, which saith, by hearing ye shall hear and shall not understand, and seeing ye shall see and shall not perceive. For this people's heart is waxed gross, and their ears are dull of hearing, and their eyes they have closed. And I personally experienced this with some old knucklehead yesterday, this exact thing, man. It was useless even speaking to them, because what they were trying to do is go off on their worldly rants, man. You know, which really is ultimately is their hearts and their personal beliefs, which further leads them to a path of destruction. You know, which when they open their mouths, it's literally you don't learn nothing, and you can't benefit from nothing they're saying to you. Literally. You know, because for this people's heart is waxed gross, and their ears are dull of hearing. He wasn't hearing a damn thing I was saying, and he couldn't even add on to it. You know how we brothers get together and we make videos together. We can add on to each other. We can compliment each other, precept upon precept, line upon line, here a little and there a little. We can compliment each other, but they're nowhere in that. They can fall nowhere in there, compliment you in your grief and your struggles and your understanding. Period. You know, because again, they're trying to make it in this world, and say, and their eyes, they have closed, lest any time they should see with their eyes and hear with their ears, and shall understand with their heart and shall be converted, and I shall heal them. But blessed are your eyes, for they see, and your ears, for they hear. And seeing, we're seeing that the narrow path is the way. That's what we're seeing. The narrow path is the way. Okay? So I might have to come back to that script. This here is 13. So let me continue on here. For the entrance of the elder world were wide and sure, and brought immortal fruit. And then they that live labor not to enter these straight and vain things, they can never receive those that are laid up for them. Now therefore, why disquieted thou thyself, seeing thou art but a corruptible man? Why art thou moved, whereas thou art but mortal? Why hast thou not considered in thy mind this thing that is to come, rather than that which is present? Then answer I and said, O Lord, that bears rule, thou hast ordained in the law that the righteous shall inherit these things, but that the ungodly should perish. Nevertheless, the righteous shall suffer straight things. Nevertheless, the righteous shall suffer straight things. Okay? And hope for the wide. And hope for the wise, for they that have done wickedly have suffered the straight things, and yet shall not see the wise. And he said unto me, there is no judge above the Most High, and none that have understanding above the highest. For there be many that perish in this life, because they despise the law of the Most High that is set before them. For the Most High have given straight commandment, to such as came, what they should do to live, even as they came, and what they should observe to avoid punishment. Nevertheless, they were not obedient unto him, but spake against him and imagined vain things. So let me do this here as well. Again, so you have understanding. Okay, it's all so you have the meaning of it. See, I thought I did this before, just not too long ago. In a video, looked up the word strait. A narrow passage of water connected by two seas. I sure did. Used in reference to a situation characterized by a specified degree of trouble or difficulty. So now you see how the churches is. The churches is easy, man. Not faced with no controversy, nor difficulty. Difficulty paying them tithes, maybe, but they're not faced with no trouble or difficulties. None at all, man. You can see a lot of them fools is taking the easy way out. They see where the masses of the people are. That's what they follow. Totally disregarding the scripture that broad is the way that leadeth to destruction. There ain't no getting away around that. There's no getting away around that. Let me do this here as well. I'm about to end this. I'm not gonna make it too long. That's really my point has been made. 7-13, here you go. Narrow and wide gates. And this is Matthew 7-13. Red letter. Enter ye in at the straight gate. For wide is the gate and broad is the way that leadeth to destruction. And many there be which go in thereat. And what does the scripture says? Acts 7-48. I think it is. I haven't gotten that scripture in so long. The Most High dwelleth not in temples made with hands. Okay? See, this house we're built, this house that we're laboring to build is not built with hands. This is a spiritual thing that we're building. This house that we're building a spiritual house, not made with hands. All right, so examining. Oh, Slocky, let me do this. Examining, because straight is the gate, and narrow is the way. You ain't no way around that. For straight is the gate, narrow straight. See, it's not really given. And like I said, like the scripture says, like I pulled up the definition of straight and narrow. You know, I gave it a definition of straight. Do I have to do it again? A specified degree of trouble and difficulty. All right, that's why you have to go, you know, it's very important. Again, you have to look up words, which is through the Spirit, actually being stressed a lot by the apostles, just going into word, looking them up. Narrow, and narrow is the way. It's that narrow, only one man can enter at one time, is the way that which leadeth unto life, and few there be that find it. So how can the broad, it says few there be that find it, but the broad, how do you explain, how do you justify that, those massive churches, how do you justify that, right? And again, it goes into the spirit. It's to say, beware of false prophets which come to you in sheep's clothing, but inwardly they are ravening wolves. And that, those false prophets they got a knack of being able to gather masses of people. You know. So I'm gonna leave it at that. And again, I hope you were informed, edified, and inspired to continue on in this straight path. This is clear to us. It's clear to us our path. It's clear to us. Just the path is distract. The path is the way of difficulty. It's clear to us, you know. And that's another example of being brought through the fire, you know. And that's the way Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai. That's his way of purifying us of all impurities, you know. And meaning impurities of things of the world, you know, the beliefs and practices and so on and so on. He's purging us of all those things. Okay? So, again, till next time, Lord willing, Shalom.